Hi dear children, welcome back to our computer class.
How are you?
How? All are good and safe. We completed lesson 7, that is introducing HTML, isn't it? Today we are going to explain that exercise of the chapter. Okay, let's start. Before that, everybody should take your textbook and a notebook. First, exercise A. Dash tag is used to start a paragraph, that is P tag. There are dash different heading levels. There are 6 different heading levels. Dash tag is used to start a new line, that is BR tag. Dash is the main tag, that is HTML. HTML is the main tag. Okay. Exercise B, write the tags for the following. To create a list, that is OL tag, that is ordered list, that is OL tag. To save the HTML file, that is file name .html. .html is the extension of HTML document. To start a new paragraph, that is P tag or paragraph tag, P tag. Next, true or false. You cannot display HTML documents on any type of computer. It's true. There is no need to close BR tag. It's true. Hypertext is the method by which you move around on the web by clicking on hyperlinks. That's true. To start a new paragraph, you use the paragraph tag in HTML document. True. The paragraph element consists of start P tag and a closing tag slash P. That is true. In HTML, the text is saved as a .html file. That is true. Okay. Next is answer the following questions. Explain the term HTML. We know that HTML is a programming language. It's used to create web pages. The full form of HTML is hypertext markup language. Isn't it? HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. It's a file, it's a text file containing small markup tags. The markup tags tell the web browser how to display the web page. An HTML file must have a .html or .html file extension. Okay. What is the HTML document structure? We know that the document structure, that means the first tag is always HTML tag. Okay, the first tag is HTML tag. Next is head tag. These tags are enclosed within angle bracket. Each tag has an opening tag and a closing tag. Okay, first tag is, that means the main tag is HTML, then head tag, then title tag. You can keep any title, that's your wish. Then slash title. After that slash head, that means closing tag. The closing tag contains one special character, that is called slash. Next is body tag. The body tag contains content of the web page. Body tag contains content of the web page. You can keep any data in this section. Okay. What are the different things you want to appear in your web page? There are things you should type in between this opening and closing of body section. The body tag contains content of the web page. Got it? After giving the content, then close body tag. After that, last, close HTML tag. Okay. HTML is the main tag. Head tag to contain heading of the web page. Next is title tag. Title tag contains title of the web page. It will appear on the title bar. Next is title tag close, head tag close. The closing tag contains one special character, that is called a slash. Next is body tag. The body tag contains content of the web page. After giving the content, close body tag and close HTML tag. Okay. Next question. What do you mean by tags? The tags are used to mark up HTML element. It's enclosed within two characters, that is angle brackets. Okay. The tags are enclosed within two characters, that is angle less than and greater than symbol, that is angle brackets. Okay. Next, the tie contain opening and closing tie. The closing tie contain one special character that is called a slash. Next, the text between start and end tag is the element content. HTML tags are not case sensitive. What is the meaning of not case sensitive? We already said we can type the data or syntax is in capital letter or small letter. Case sensitive means we have two cases, that is upper cases and lower case. Upper case means capital letter, lower case means small letter. We can type the syntax is in capital letter or in small letter. That is same. The tags are not case sensitive. Not case sensitive. Upper case and lower case are the two cases. Okay. You can type the syntax in capital or in small letter. Next is, write the code to use heading levels in the web page. Which are the heading levels? How many heading levels are there? There are 6 heading levels from H1 to H6. Okay. Each heading level has an opening tag and a closing tag. That means H1, that is the first heading level. After type the data, then close H1, that means slash H1. Then H2. Okay. H2, after typing the data, then close H2. Each heading level has an opening tag and a closing tag. 6 heading levels are there from H1 to H6. Okay. Next, write the code to use paragraph tag in the web page. We know that the paragraph tag is P tag. Which is the paragraph tag? That is P tag. P tag is the paragraph tag. It contains opening tag and a closing tag. Okay. P tag contains opening and a closing tag. Same as like that, heading levels. How many heading levels are there? H1 to H6. Okay. 6 heading levels are there from H1 to H6. Okay. That's all. The chapter is over. Everybody should study nicely. Write and study the syntaxes. Okay. If you have any doubt, then ask me. Okay, dear children. Thank you. And have a nice day. Bye-bye.